Hello, Pisces. Thank you so much for checking out this video. This is going to be a love reading for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. It will not resonate with every Pisces watching, so please keep that in mind. If it doesn't resonate, check out your other placements. Sometimes those can resonate more. And just take what resonates and leaves the rest. Leave the rest. Okay, Pisces, let's get into it. Spirit, what messages do you have for Pisces? This is the Osho Sen Tarot deck. You can find all the tarot decks that I use linked down below. For Pisces. Huge thank you to everyone who has liked, shared, commented, subscribed. I really appreciate it. We got celebration. Three of Cups energy here. Innocence and participation. Wow. This could be a third party situation. I feel like there's a lot of people here. This to me is four people with their hands extended, three people here. Let's see. Existence. Oh, wow, the Fool under the deck. Something new. Oh, there's something behind there. Inner voice, I didn't see that. Intuition. Intuition is at play here. I didn't mean to pick so many, but we're gonna go with it. I feel like someone's thinking or manifesting or seeing the potential of something here. With Innocence and the Fool on the bottom of the deck, this is like new energy for me. Someone wanting to begin again or start something fresh. With participation and celebration, though, I'm getting that there's some sort of interference or too many people involved here in some way. All right, Pisces, let's get into it. Spirit, what messages do you have for Pisces? Let's get into the tarot. This is a Druid Craft tarot deck. It's huge, but I love it. Messages for Pisces, please. All right, Pisces, let's see what we have for you. I'm gonna clarify, wow, that one went flying. I'm gonna clarify all of these with a different deck. Spirit, messages for Pisces in regards to love, please. The World reversed, unfinished business for some of you. Nine of Cups. Someone's gonna be happy about something here. Unfinished business. Unable to move on, unable to close a chapter, or refusing to close a chapter here. Two of Pentacles reversed. So someone could have finally made a decision. The ball dropped for someone here. If they were taking too long juggling something, could have been people, could have been work, anything like that. One of those balls has dropped, or one of those coins has dropped. And they've been forced to make a decision, or they've chosen to specifically drop one for the other. We'll see. We're going to clarify those. Any other messages for Pisces, please? Seven of Cups. I saw this while I was shuffling. Daydreaming, fantasizing. Someone has options here. Ace of Cups and the Empress reversed. Wow. Someone was unable to manifest something. Something wasn't able to grow. This could also be a jilted lover for me as a reader. But we're ending with the Ace of Cups. Wow, someone has made a decision. If this is a third party situation, I'm getting the sense that someone has made a decision. Bottom of the deck, the Sun. Could be dealing with a Leo. But this is like happiness. Someone is choosing their happiness here, and it's gonna piss someone off with the Empress reversed. I feel like someone's going to be upset or left behind here due to someone's decision. Someone is choosing. Someone's listening to their intuition about manifesting or the potential of something else. And I keep getting this theme in a lot of the readings. I feel like a lot of people have been realizing where they are in life, especially right now. All we can do is really think. I feel like there's been a lot of realizations or things that have come to light people that are seeing things clearly for the first time or for the first time in a long time. So let's see. Let's get into this, Pisces. See what this is all about. This is the Barbara Moore Tarot. Oh my goodness. Okay. Tell me about the Nine of Cups for Pisces. What is this Nine of Cups about for Pisces? This is all about wish fulfillment, getting something that you wanted, feeling satisfied and content. Wow, Ten of Cups, Ace of Wands reversed. Interesting. Something here didn't pan out, didn't work, but someone's happy about that. This could have been related to a family. Something wasn't able to be created or manifested here. But someone here, that was their wish. Four of Pentacles reversed. So if this is, I feel like someone has let go of something, possibly a commitment or, again, the family, the Ten of Cups to me, I'm getting a lot of, I'm getting people, four people in that card. There's children possibly involved because I have the Sun here and I have the Ten of Cups. Someone has let go of something here. Four of Cups at the bottom of the deck. So there was disinterest, boredom. Someone has mentally or emotionally checked out of something here. They're letting go possibly of a family situation, something that wasn't able to get off the ground, wasn't successful. But for some reason, this is making them happy or they're satisfied with this. Tell me about the World reverse. Thank you. King of Cups, Five of Wands reversed. Someone here is completely like overcoming. Okay. So with the Five of Wands reversed, I'm getting that there was drama. Again, too many people involved here. There was possibly arguing, disagreements, but hurtful arguments. So this King of Cups is kind of like over this. It's almost like this King of Cups is too good for this, or his maturity has led him to let this go. This Five of Wands energy reverse is beneath him. You know, he's not going to be playing around or fighting or constantly arguing and bickering. And we have this with the World reverse. And the Moon reversed, sign of Pisces. This King of Cups, his intuition, he's very intuitive. And I feel like his intuition has alerted him or shown him that there is something here that is not what it seems. This is not going anywhere. This is arguing and bickering, and there's some sort of revelation here. Bottom of the deck, Six of Cups. This King of Cups could be wanting a do-over, or there's unfinished business. There's lack of closure here with someone from the past, possibly. Five of Cups, yeah, something didn't work out in the past. It's been a burden for this person. This person has felt stuck in the past, possibly. They can't let go of something that happened in the past. But I can tell you that whatever came out, whatever was revealed here with the Moon reversed, it caused a lot of arguments, fighting, a lot of bickering. A lot of people involved again, like I said. But this King of Cups, I'm telling you, he is emotionally stable. And this is could be you, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio here. There's somebody emotionally stable who doesn't let his emotions control him, though. So it's almost like this person is like above the fray. Like they're not being pulled down by someone's negative energy here. I feel like they're focused. Tell me about this Two of Pentacles reversed. What's this Two of Pentacles reversed about? So this is a decision here. Can't talk. Five of Pentacles. Someone could have been juggling too much. Financial struggles possibly here. Needing help. Page of Cups. Wow. Someone could be wanting to come out of the cold, apologize, yeah, for something painful. Could be a third party as well. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, again, someone here wants to apologize or express how they feel. They've been left out in the cold. They've been possibly debating about approaching someone because there's been a lot of pain in this relationship or connection. Six of Cups at the bottom of the deck again. This could be someone from the past, I'm telling you. And it doesn't have to be an ex. It could be anybody from your past. But I'm getting that this person knows somebody. Something was painful or disappointing for this person. Yeah, they want to come back. There's been delays. Tell me about the Seven of Cups. I feel like this person has been imagining, like, how to go about this. Evaluating. Wow, Two of Cups reversed. What else can you tell me about the Seven of Cups, please? Wow, okay. We got here Two of Cups reversed. So some sort of partnership that did not work out here. Queen of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. And then we have the Four of Swords. Someone's healing from or has healed from something that didn't work out here. Something that was painful. And now they're ready to move on, make a move somewhere else. I'm also noticing that this person here has a big sun. And I have the sun here. Lions here. You could definitely be dealing with a Leo. Doesn't have to be. But this is someone who sees options now that they've healed from something that didn't work out. It's almost like they got their wish without knowing about it. Or they realized that what didn't work out for them was a blessing. Because it's allowed them to have a second chance, more options. The possibility of something else. I have Seven of Wands at the bottom of the deck here. Very interesting. Whoever this is, I feel like they're facing opposition right now. There's the Empress reversed again. This Empress reversed. Wow. This Empress reversed is going to fight this person to try to keep them from moving on. I feel like this is the person they're leaving. Whether it's you or the person, whoever's leaving someone here, they're dealing with an Empress reversed. This is someone who is manipulative, controlling, way too controlling, smothering. They are not very stable. They're not good partners either. They're not good parents, like good mothers. There's nothing here that can grow or manifest because of this person. I feel like there's going to be opposition from this Empress reversed, and this person's going to have to fight for their new beginning. So let's get more insight into this Empress reverse. Tell me more about this Empress reverse, please, for Pisces. For Pisces, why is this Empress reversed? Three of Cups reversed, because someone's choosing someone else. This was a love triangle of some sort. Also, I just heard in my head, party's over. Ten of Wands, King of Wands reversed. This Empress reverse is mad, upset. Someone's choosing a third party. Someone's making a decision to drop a burden. There's a Queen of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Someone's cutting this Empress reversed off, and she's very upset about it. There could also be a Queen of Swords with this person. Again, I have Queen of Wands, Queen of Swords, the Empress reversed, King of Wands reversed, King of Cups. You know, I'm getting a lot of people here. So there could be family involved, friends involved in this connection. There's interference here. Again, I'm getting the sense that this King of Cups is choosing someone else over this Empress. And she's not happy about it. Tell me about this Ace of Cups. The new love. Abundance. Emotional fulfillment. Tell me about this Ace of Cups. For Pisces, please. Queen of Swords. So this King of Cups could be going after this Queen of Swords. Yeah, it could be a Gemini. What else for the Ace of Cups? Thank you. Hierophant. Wow. Wow. This is leading towards long-term commitment, a very passionate union, a very special connection here. With the Knight of Wands reversed at the bottom of the deck, this could be someone who possibly was not committed, not willing to commit at some point. Yeah, they were not willing to commit at some point, but now they're ready for a new cycle here. This could also be someone who possibly was selfish back in your, like in the past. This person, I feel like they got shut out by someone here for being, for thinking of themselves. Yeah, could be dealing with a Virgo, it doesn't have to be, but this is someone who has listened to their intuition, has realized something. They've withdrawn to learn more about themselves and their part, the part they played in the past. And that's why they want, it's almost like they never got closure because of their own actions. But now they're thinking of new love with possibly a Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. This Queen of Swords is also someone who is very direct. So it's almost like this person wants to communicate in a rational way. Hey, I want to do this long term. The real deal. Full on commitment. You're all I want. I'm sorry for being such a jerk in the past or not knowing what I wanted at the time or treating you badly at the time, etc., etc. Because this Page of Cups, remember, could be an apology. So that's what I'm seeing, Pisces. Thank you to everyone once again for liking, subscribing, commenting. I really appreciate it. And if this did not resonate with you, then check out your other placements. Sometimes you can get more messages there that resonate. So yeah, thank you so much, Pisces. And I'll see you guys in another video. Take care.